What's going on, folks? Me on Cloud Fetty.
Back at it.
With another dope topic, as promised. Hope everybody is well. Tonight's topic is how we met.
Yay! Ding, ding, ding.
Everybody wants to know. Yes. Not everybody knows the story.
Not everybody looks through all the videos.
Right.
Because we've mentioned it, but,
yeah. It's still important, and it's always good to reiterate. So, would you like to start it off?
Nah, you kick it off. Right. I feel like I'm always telling the story.
Okay, so basically how we met is we both met on Black People Meet.
Wait, I got a suggestion. People always hear my side of the story. Why don't you say where you was at that time of when we met? Like, I always say...
Mentally or...
Okay, so like,
wise, or?
I always tell the story like I was just sick and tired.
Okay.
Me and my cousin was New Year's resolution and we signed up because we wanted to take a chance. But what was your thought process in going on the site? Why don't you tell that story?
My thought process going on the site was I thought it would be easier for me to meet people.
Okay.
I wasn't always a club guy. Bar hopping every night. I never did any of that. School, I went to school at nights. So it was harder. People getting home from work, everybody tired, won't go home. So I thought it was a good way for me to demonstrate my attributes, meaning my profile and females' profiles, getting an idea of who they are. And again, I wasn't having expectations at all. I wasn't at a point of life like, oh man, I'm just tired of dating. I'm just ready to get married already. I'm okay. Sick of this. No.
Well, I wasn't thinking that either. I just wanted to meet a decent person.
I wanted to meet somebody decent. I thought that would help filter that out.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, that's not always the case. You meet somebody crazy anyway. It don't matter. So, for me, it was just about taking my time, seeing where things go.
Okay.
Dating. I wasn't rushing. I wasn't putting things on a pedestal. Again, I wasn't coming in with expectations. And I think that worked out in my favor. Or, who knows, maybe I would have messed up relationships or overdid it because I was expecting something, you know, trying to force
something.
So
you didn't have no expectations. You just kind of went on there because you wanted to meet people.
Right.
And you weren't meeting people in your daily commuting and all that stuff.
Right.
Cool. So, take it back to the beginning. We met on blackpeoplemeet.com.
Of all places, I definitely wouldn't think I'd find my wife on Black People Meet or any of these dating sites, to be honest with you.
Okay, so what made you pick that site? Like,
I think I kept seeing the commercials.
Okay.
I don't remember. Maybe someone could have mentioned it to me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think they did a good job of marketing.
Yeah, back then. I don't see it at all anymore.
Professionals. I think that was the kick in. So someone could have suggested, like, yo, why don't you go on Black People Meet? You're a young Black professional. You know, you can meet like-minded peers on there, and I was like, all right, people mention it, give it a shot. And I tried it out.
So I know you told me like you went on dates with other people prior, mm-hmm. or whatever.
Right.
What made you message me?
You were very attractive. To be honest with you, I don't remember too much about your profile. Apparently, you was decent. In the bio, it wasn't really anything that, you know, stood out other than you was looking to meet someone,
mm-hmm.
Something serious, you know, a little bit about yourself, like the typical stuff. So I was like, all right, you know, she sounds decent. Like, you didn't have anything in the bio that's like extra that's like, whoa, what's this mean? And
so you actually read the bio?
Yeah, I do that, skim through it at least.
I did too. For me, when I saw your page, your pictures,
you
was,
loved it?
Your
you
pictures,
loved it?
Your pictures was trash, man. I'm being real.
That's
because
I had a Samsung Galaxy at the time.
Oh my God.
So that's why, you know, Samsung was just horrible.
You see what you see here? You was not getting that from the picture. The pictures was mad close.
I think I was on some lazy shit then.
Yeah,
like,
no.
Yeah.
And then you had
good enough.
You had like, you know, remember the back in the day, the camera that come with the computer, or you take pictures with the laptop or whatever. Like I could tell you did that. Like you just took a profile picture with your laptop or something.
I don't think I think it was my cell phone, but I didn't just put any thought into it. Looked bad. I just like snapped it real quick, so like, lazy.
He didn't have one, no clothes, no nothing. It was just like a picture.
I was butt naked, yeah.
Meaning like you just had on a t-shirt and your glasses. And that was it. Like, the picture wasn't selling a story. It just was like, okay, he seems like a nice guy from reading the bio. But I think at that time, I was like, okay, he seems nice. He's not hitting me with no, yo, ma, what's good? Yeah. He, you know,
It was trash, though. Like,
the pictures was bad. You see how fine he is? That was not in the picture.
It was laziness, just like,
yo, we need to find that
I don't know
bio.
What I'm doing. Let me just put something up to, like, fill in the profile. You know how they give you, like, percentages? God. Like, you're 70% done. So I think probably at that point, I'm like, yo, here, man, fill it up 100%. Let me start moving on and browsing.
Okay. So I know in the beginning when we connected, we were like message on the site.
Yes.
And then it kind of went to texting off the site.
Yes.
I took like a whole month to meet up with you. What was your thoughts about that? Like, were you feeling like I was dragging my feet? Or did you feel like it was cool with you because of your work schedule and graduate school?
Yeah, it was cool, my work schedule, graduate school, and I was dating also.
Okay, so it didn't feel like I was dragging my feet to you?
No.
Okay, cool. But you used to, like, text me every morning, like, have a great day, da-da-da-da. Is that just your pitch you was doing to all the girls you was dating? Or
like,
was it
a good morning text?
Yes, or was it, like, I kind of have an interest in this girl, let me send that, or that was just your pitch to chicks?
If I was interested in you, I would do that. If I was
you ain't doing answering that, the question, man.
If I'm interested, yes, I was interested in you.
No, so I'm talking about you. Period. Like
that wasn't my game like that.
Okay.
You know, I wouldn't be able to do that with like five or six women consistently. I would forget two or three of them if I constantly did that.
How?
You would have to stick with me and I would have to see something there, like there's right. potential for another date. This could be something. Let's see how it goes. Like, I would have to get that type of spark before I would do something like that.
Gotcha.
I have done it before, but consistently with a lot of people, no.
Alright. So, now, let's fast forward. So, the whole time we were, like, talking off of the site, he would text me, I would text him. I was kind of cool with that. And then somewhere along the line of me just texting him, finding out more about him, I was like, well, this guy's kind of interesting, you know. He might be a little something, because I wasn't really taking it that serious. I think I should have, but I don't think I was taking it that serious, because one, he was 3 years younger than me. Two, I had got out of something that was real shaky, and I just was, like, not a believer that I could really meet a decent person online. So it was a lot of things that I just was like, eh. But something about him was making me keep talking to him and feel him out. Then I think he asked me to send him like full body pictures or whatever, because most people just send like the headshots or whatever the case is. And him too, all he had was like his face or whatever. So he said to send it to him and I did. He responds like, wow, you look good or whatever. And then he sends me his. And then I was like, oh, I think that was the wake up for me.
Eye opener. That should pay me attention.
When he sent me the pictures, like of pictures that he took of himself, like in his suit and at work, or like, you know, out and about, showed his style and all that. I was like, okay, I got a better idea of who I was talking to. So I was like, okay, this guy's kind of fly. Like, but his pictures online did not show that. Okay. Mm-hmm. Like, it was just, anyway. So then I was like, oh, you in graduate school? You good looking? You got style? You know what? Yes, I'm shallow in a little bit, but I mean, you was looking at
that's
looks.
Standards.
Too.
I want somebody that, you know.
So, that's when I was like, maybe I should meet up with him. And then I told you that, and you was like, cool, you agreed. And the night, I always remember this, the night before we were supposed to meet, mind you, I never spoke to him on the phone. It was just text, text, text. So the night before we're supposed to meet, all of a sudden he calls. And I'm looking at my phone like, why is he calling me? Like,
because we constantly were texting. Let me at least speak to her real quick. Now, I think I was getting ready to go to bed or something like that. So I'm like, yo, let me speak to her real quick to confirm.
And I was like, I hope he don't sound like a girl.
Really, women think about this stuff? Like, that's yes. the last thing. I would be like,
yo, what if I had some super like, deep voice? Like, it, meaning because it was like...
I would have dealt with it if you did, but I'm not expecting anything other than you to sound like a woman. Like, oh, okay,
I sure. know, but I'm just saying is that so far through text, the conversation was good. We were vibing and all that stuff. So I was just like, so in my mind, I always was feeling like something got to be wrong with him. Type of thing, because I felt like this guy is too cookie cutter, he's too good looking, he's too nice, so I felt like something had to be jacked up with him. I found out there's something later on, we'll get to that, but it's not what you think, but anyway, he called and I was just like, what if he sound like a girl, why is he calling me, da, da, da. Anyway, I finally picked up and he sounded like real cute and I was like, oh, okay. And yeah, so what did you feel like when we first met up? The first date, if you could recall.
It was very dim and dark.
Yeah, so you picked the place.
It set the tone. It was a bar. Yeah. Not too far from the school I was going to.
Mm-hmm.
Out in Manhattan. And you seemed very nice. You had a nice smile. You didn't seem like nothing was wrong with you. Like crazy. And just to touch up briefly on that. Okay, you came out of something shaky. You know, you was tired of this, you was tired of that. I thank you so much for not bringing that energy towards the relationship, because if you did, it would have turned me off and it would have went left. So I didn't know all of those things. I found out those things about her later on, which I appreciate. But definitely, you didn't come in with like a messed up attitude because of a prior relationship or situation. That affects a lot of stuff. So I wanted to highlight that because sometimes people do that. But yeah, I thought you were very nice. You had a nice smile. You pretty. You like the person actually in the photo.
You told me I look prettier than
no catfish. Than the right. Absolutely. You had nice conversation. You were very open-minded. It was just such an easy like flow.
Can I keep it real with you?
Yeah.
Well, I think I told you that already, but you had me like a little nervous because you was so like serious and I just was like, I couldn't read you. Like the jokey guy, the way that we joke with each other now, like I didn't know you was that person when I met you. I mean, I'm glad you didn't come off like goofy, whatever, but you came off really serious. Like, You one of the questions you was like, where do you see yourself in 5 years? And I was like, yo, this guy is like real deal. Like he really get into the thing. And I was like, why is he? And he, mind you, he's 3 years younger. So I was just like, why is he so like? So anyway, I was just like, and then he kept saying like he's met other people on the site or he's met other ladies, and it was just like no chemistry, no fizzle, no nothing. Like they were nice people. He's like, you know, I dated some lawyers. I dated some attorneys or something. And da-da-da. And some doctors, some nurses. He was like, you know, just wasn't no connection. Nice people, but no connection. Right. So the whole date, I'm sitting there like, what the hell? Like, is he connected with me? Is he going to go home and tell people?
Am I picky? Right?
Yeah, like, it was just like, I couldn't really read him. Mm-hmm. So that was how I was feeling on the first date. But at the end of the date, when he walked into the train, he kissed me. And I just was like, where the hell that came from?
Why don't you be glad that I did that instead of you complaining about
no,
it?
No, because
never
I couldn't
not enjoy the
because
moment.
I couldn't read you, so I was just like, I guess he likes me. It was just
yeah, I thought it was a good opportunity to do that. I thought you enjoyed yourself on a date too. Or I wouldn't have.
I did, but it's like that. You know, I couldn't read you, and he was telling me all this stuff about how you dated other women, just was no connection, no chemistry. Mm-hmm. And then you asked me where I see myself in 5 years. So in my head, it's like, am I answering these questions right? Kind of felt partially like an interview. I couldn't tell if he was looking at me as one of those women that didn't have chemistry with you. And then at the end of the day, it was like, bam, kiss on the lips. And I was like, okay. And then he like left, and I went on the train. But I was like, I knew I liked him, and I was interested. And I wanted to see him again, but I just was like, I couldn't read you.
My point of asking those questions was not to be picky or ridicule you. It was just more so to see, like, how was your thought process with, life in the future. And then I wanted to stimulate some type of conversation. Sometimes women get quiet and it gets awkward, and it's like the man or someone has to lead the conversation. So to make sure that ain't happen for at least 10, 15 minutes, I like to ask those questions. It's good conversation starters, but not like, hey, credit better be 700 if she say 699.
He was giving me like, that vibe, child.
But, you know, it worked out well. I enjoyed it, and it seemed like you enjoyed it.
Yeah, it was different. And I think that's why we're here. That's why we're married, because it was definitely different than any date I have been on. In a good way, because I felt like he was actually taking an interest. He was listening to me. He was asking me questions about myself. And maybe I've never experienced that from a dude prior to him. So to me, it was weird. Right. Or I was like, what kind of vibe is this? But maybe those are the questions that a guy that's going to be your future husband is trying to ask you, because he's trying to get to know you on all levels.
I want to know what you want to be, what you want, and all that stuff. I think on a date, or if I'm interested and woman seems legitimate, I want to kind of walk away with those things. Like, oh, well, she's currently this, that. She wants to be this. And she really likes this. She seemed cool. I'll find out more about her on the next day. But that's kind of what the tactic was for that. There's no right way to answer that question.
Yes. But what I liked about you and how we met is that regardless of what, we just flowed.
Yes.
We always flowed. Like, we just flowed. I don't know how to say it. Like, it was never no arguments, no nothing. It was just a flow. We always had a flow about us. And even now, we still have a flow. And I don't know if we, like, we get into things, but nothing too serious. But me and you just always got along naturally. Like, it just seemed effortlessly. And that's what always stayed in my head. Now, I know everybody makes a comment like, oh, your husband, he's good looking, he's fine, he's this. Yes, he is. But honest speaking, it was the way that he made me feel, the way that he made me feel so comfortable to be myself with him. And the flow, like, I just always felt good around him. Like, I could be myself and, you know, I enjoyed his company. Yeah, that was the chemistry for me. Right. So him being good looking, seriously, I know people don't believe it, but it's like, him being good looking was never the forefront in my head. It was more so how he made me feel. And that always stood out to me when dating you. Like, I was just like, I just like this guy. I don't know how to explain, I just like him. So, yeah.
Same here. You know, that's how I thought about you. Minus the looks and everything else. Oh, it was like, I really get along with this person. You know, I laugh with this person. We have good times.
So I mean, wanted to know what chemistry the other people didn't have.
Just didn't know. Maybe they was nervous. Or again, people get in their own way. People put walls up. Things.
Maybe
that
you
nature.
Made them nervous.
Maybe. You know, could have been the day. The time of the day it was. The way I came off, you know.
Because I did have a few friends that maybe they were haters, but from looking at your pictures alone, it was just like, oh, he look like, you know, a way like stuck up or whatever the case is. I mean, it's perception. So I don't know. Maybe.
Because I'm not going to look at a photo. I don't believe in that much speculation.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not going to get warped into somebody's photo if I feel like they're mutually interested and try to pick apart what I think their personality is going to be like or whatever. If you're drop dead gorgeous, dimed out, and you want to go on a date, then it's going to be very little thoughts of, you know, bougie, sophisticated, high class. Like, see where it goes. Because a lot of people have that look and they're very nice people. Nobody could never give them a chance. That's why a lot of them are single.
That is true.
So it's like, it's silly versus I get more from you based on conversation, vibe, energy. You know, that's what will tell me a lot about a person. So that's what I look forward to. You know, if I'm attracted to you, I'm attracted to you. I could check that off the list, and then I can kind of move down on other stuff that I want to look for.
My husband is very difficult to read, though. Like, I mean, now, because, you know, we've been together for a long time, I could tell the tone of his voice. If he likes something, if you're not really into it, he will never come out and say it because he's a nice person. But I could tell from his tone, but I just could not read him in the beginning. I knew he liked me because he kept inviting me out every week, like, yo, let's go out. I got this place I found. Let's go do this. Let's go. And I was like, okay, you know, whatever. And just history from there. I don't know what type of story I was expecting on how we met. But we met from blackpeoplemeet.com. It was a shot in the dark. I mean, I have went on other sites before and came off or whatever. But with this one, I literally signed up and he messaged me. And the rest is history.
I'm also a different type of guy. If something is going good and I like something, I want to keep it going. I'm not going to be like, all right, well, move on to the next. That was real good. And then try to come back afterwards like, oh, yeah, let's try to pick up from where. No, let's keep this going while it's going good. And enjoy ourselves. That's just how I am. If I find a spot, like a food spot that I like, then regularly I'll try to go there. Same thing, like some guys, you know, they're inconsistent from what I hear. They
are they?
You know, they do it, it goes good, then the woman doesn't know what happened.
Yeah.
I'm not like that. If it's good, I'm gonna keep coming back. So that's why we kept going on dates, because the vibe was good. It felt
good. But I still couldn't. I still couldn't read him. And I remember the second date. The first date, he was like off from school that day and just going to work. Like, no. Just going to class. So he came dressed down. And the second date, the following week when we met up, you came with your three-piece suit. And you was like, you know, from work or whatever. And I was like, well, damn, like, he was looking real good. My husband looked real good. And the suit looked good and everything. But the suit was just like,
hey, you make me blush.
I like a businessman. I love it. So he looked very clean cut, very attractive, very nice. And I was just like, you know, and I remember that second date, we was kissing nonstop like crazy. Them people in the bar probably was like, we actually went back to that bar to tell them, like, we got married because we were there all the time.
That's the spot, man.
Like, he would come in and just give his card, and we would just be there for hours.
They know what drink I want. They move quick. It felt like family. It felt like cheers. You know what I'm saying? So, definitely, if I like somebody and they don't know where to go, I'm going to bring them over there, because that's definitely my comfort zone. And then I could just chill.
Yeah,
and then,
you took other people there, but they never made it back for second, third, fourth. It's cool. It was it became our spot, and we went back, but you know, it was like different staff. Nice. But I know they would love to hear the story that we're like married for 3 years, been together 7. So that was where it started, at that bar. But I didn't know how to read him. I just knew that we kind of liked each other and stuff like that. And I remember the more like 4 months in, I was like, I'm really feeling this guy. I'm like telling my friends and like, oh my god. Like, he's Mr. Awesome. That's why I used to call him, because I couldn't find anything bad to say about him. Oh, and
so you always know what to say.
I remember in my head, I was like, you know, I don't want to keep dating him, and it's like he don't want nothing serious. Like, I just kept feeling like he just can't be this good. Like, something got to be off, because I was so used to dealing with inconsistent jerks. Yeah. So I remember that weekend, I was like, yo, I'm going to put it out there. I'm going to tell him, like, I want to be exclusive. And if that's not what he's looking for, then he could do what he do. And that's it. And that same weekend, he came to Brooklyn. And we was hanging out. We was in the kitchen. And he was like, I said something like, well, you know, if I'm dating other people. And he was like, nah, I don't want you dating nobody else. And I was like, whoa. And basically, he was like, you know, you exclusive, you mine, you everything. And it was like, this is my husband right here, because it's like he read my thoughts and he came with it before I even said it, because I'm building up all week to have this talk with him, and he comes in casual as ever and just X's that right off my list from having to have that conversation with him. So I was like, damn, we on the
same. It felt right. And again, it was something that was going good, where it's like different scenarios, different angles, this is working. So at that point, give it a shot. If everything, you know, is going well, again, logic, that's how I think. Now, if something go wrong, then that's when I question. But if it's going good, then, and it feels right, what could it, you know? Like, logically, that makes sense to me.
Yeah, so, that's how we met.
Yes.
Became exclusive, like, 4 months after dating.
Yes.
The dating process was cool. We became official.
Yep.
And then after a year, I introduced him to, like, my family.
Yes.
Then after 2 years, he moved in. And then at the end of the 2 years, he proposed. And then after that, we got married, and the rest is history. But I'll tell you this, ladies and gents, when you do meet the right person, it flows. It's like a natural, unspoken connection that just flows. That's why when you find people, be like, how do you know it was the one? And you, like, you're not satisfied with the answer they give, because you just know. It's just, yeah, it's just something, like, different.
There's nothing that anybody can talk you out of. It's, yeah, nothing that you're going to sound unsure about. You'll just know. Yeah. Maybe you'll have a tough time explaining it, like me. You know, like, I didn't write a book on how we got married and what's the key to getting married and how it works. And guys ask me that too. I tell them pretty much the same thing in one sentence. You just know.
You know.
You know, and when you're talking to people that have known you longer than I've known her, and they're like, what do you mean? And I'm like, look, well, I'm just telling you, this is what's happening. So either you with it or you not. When you have that confidence and stuff like that, then that's when they're the one. Then that's when you know.
Yeah.
And then that's when things will proceed and move along nicely. So,
yeah. So you can't look for advice or somebody's opinion on what the one feels like. It's only something you yourself will feel and know. Somebody can't make you feel that or tell you how it's going to feel. It's just something you yourself will notice, like, this is different. It flows. It feels good inside. We're connected. I'm not concerned if I'm going to hear from him again or hear from her again. It's just like an unspoken trust.
You know,
or
where you stand.
Yeah, exactly. Like, all of those unanswered questions you've had before feels answered. And you just know. So, this is how I met Mr. Awesome.
Fetty says.
Fetty says. All these different freaking names.
But, yeah, that's pretty much how we met. Nothing special. So, again, you can meet your dream person or your soulmate or your husband or your wife. You can meet them anywhere.
Exactly.
There's no, like, predetermined, you know, check off list and guide outline. It just pretty much flows. I think you have to be open-minded. I think you can't bring negative energy into the situation.
True.
Those are key takeaways.
Because, like he said before, prior to him, I was, like, in a horrible situation. But I told myself to not let that situation stop me from finding my happiness.
Especially trust issues early on, you know. Hey, you didn't answer your phone yet. Oh,
nah,
you're playing
games,
like, and
that.
Then it's like, whoa, like, what's happening here? And then it's from something prior, but that happens often.
That's how, and I know, too, it was, like, God, or it was, like, meant to be type of thing for me, because I never felt like that with him. Like, I never questioned, like, why isn't his phone hit on? Why isn't this? Why didn't he do this? Well, he never gave me a reason to feel that way, because he was communicating every day. He was consistent. And he's like that now. We could be sitting on the couch and he'll text me like, you're beautiful or whatever. And my husband has been like that from day one. So I just feel like, although I came out of something horrible, I never bought it to him, because he never gave me that feeling to not trust him. So that's how you know. It just felt different. I don't know why I didn't bring that nasty baggage. I'm glad I didn't. But I was just ready to move on and to have my happiness and to forget that I was ever a part of that old life. So,
chapter closed.
Yes.
So we're going to keep coming with more dope topics, guys.
Tell us how you met your partner.
Right. And if you guys have any questions either, you know, some of you guys lose hope. Some of you don't have any at all. Thank you. So, you know, hopefully.
Don't lose hope.
Yeah, but I'm using the word hope too much, but hopefully this could spark something. Again, love comes when you're not looking for it. I was just looking to date somebody decent and really build a friendship.
Yeah.
And then let it go from there. But it turned out to be much more. I didn't have any expectations. Sometimes maybe the best expectations you'll get out of something, or the best results you'll get out of something, is when you don't have expectations.
That is true, because I just was trying to get up out the house and to get out the funk and to not die old maid. I was trying to put myself out there and just enjoy my life. And in that, I found my husband. So it's true. You never know.
Yep. So you guys have a good night. We'll see y'all soon with the next episode. Sorry.
Apple Fetty says.
Share, like, comment, give us scenarios, ask us questions, suggestions, or more topics. We always welcome that. Take care.
Bye.